Madam Speaker, I would like to wish a very happy new year to all my colleagues and to the youngsters who have come to see this speech today, and also to all the citizens of the country. It is a tragedy that our friends in the AIDMK are not allowing a debate and are trying to protect the Prime Minister. This debate is about the Rafael issue, and it is a tragedy that members of the AIDMK who represent Tamil Nadu are doing the service for the BJP. Anyway, as a opposition leader, my job is to raise questions on the government. I watched the interview of the Prime Minister, part of the interview of the Prime Minister yesterday, and he spoke for almost 1.5 hours on different issues. And in the interview, he said that no one is raising the question with regards to him on Rafael, that no one is accusing the Prime Minister on Rafael. Well, I'd like to say in the House that that is not true. The entire nation is asking a direct question about the Prime Minister. And the entire nation is asking why the Prime Minister can speak for 1.5 hours in a staged interview and not answer the fundamental questions of Rafael. The questions of Rafael occur on three pillars. The first pillar is the process with regards to the deal. The second pillar is the pricing. And the third and most interesting pillar is paisa, patronage. So I would like to say a little bit about all three of these pillars. And these are questions that we have been asking the Prime Minister from the beginning. The Rafael aircraft was chosen after dedicated work, after 8 years of work by the Air Force. Senior officers of the Air Force chose the Rafael aircraft after a long negotiation. And the Air Force wanted 126 aircraft. Now the question is, why was the demand for 126 aircraft changed to 36 aircraft? Who changed the requirement of the Air Force from 126 to 36? Did something change with the requirement of national security? Did the Air Force request the government? Did the Air Force ask the government, tell the government that no, we do not want 126 planes, we want only 36 planes? That is one question. Another related question: the excuse given for 36 aircraft was that we needed the aircraft urgently. Well, then I would like to ask the question, if you needed the aircraft urgently, why is it that not a single Rafael aircraft has landed on Indian soil until today? The entire procedure of the deal, from the beginning to the end, was bypassed. The Defence Minister, Mr. Parikar, was asked whether he knew about the new deal that bypassed the old deal. Mr. Parikar himself said, "I have no idea about the new deal." The Defence Minister stated this. The Cabinet Committee on Security, which is supposed to authorize any deal, gave no authorization. This is a known fact. It has come out in a large number of newspapers, but the Prime Minister does not have a comment. So, one fundamental question, starting question to the Prime Minister. You changed the old deal of 126 aircraft and replaced it with a new deal of 36 aircraft. Did the Air Force change their demand for the number of planes, or did you unilaterally, without asking the Air Force, change this demand? So that is question number one. The second question, and this is the question on pricing. Everybody knows that the Rafale aircraft that the UPA was going to buy was going to be bought for 526 crore rupees an aircraft. This is a fact, everybody knows it. When Narendra Modi ji went to France, he met the then president of France, Mr. Hollande, and a new deal was constructed. The price of the aircraft under the new deal went from 526 crores to 1600 crores. So the next question to the Prime Minister is, why did the price go from 526 crores to 1600 crores? Why did the President of France in a public statement clearly say that the Prime Minister of India himself told me that the new price would be valid and that the contract would be taken away from HAL and given to Mr. Ambani on his behest? Another question to the Prime Minister. Is it or is it not a fact that the new price that you negotiated, 1600 crore, was objected to by the Defence Ministry officials? Is there an objection to this new price put forward by the Defence Ministry? That is a question, another question on pricing. Finally, we come to the question of paisa or patronage. Now, HAL has been making aircraft for 70 years. The NAT aircraft was responsible for winning the 1965 war. Su-30 aircraft, Mirage aircraft, MiG-27 aircraft, these were all helped. The HAL constructed these aircraft. So HAL has a tremendous record, and HAL is the potential future aviation industry of this country. HAL gives jobs to thousands of youngsters, and HAL is the bedrock of technology in this country, has tremendous successes. On the other side, Mr. Anil Ambani, a failed businessman. 45,000 crore rupees in debt. Mr. Anil Ambani opens a company 10 days before he receives the HAL contract. The President of France says the Prime Minister of India has ordered us to give this contract to Mr. Anil Ambani. Mr. Anil Ambani has a plot of land into which was purchased by money given by Dassault to Mr. Anil Ambani. So the next question is, dear Prime Minister, why did you give this contract to your dear friend Mr. Anil Ambani and cost the exchequer 30,000 crore rupees? Why did you take this contract away? Why did you take this contract away from HAL and give Mr. Anil Ambani 30,000 crores? I see here the Defence Minister sitting, hiding behind the AIDMK people. I can see her hiding and I can see her smiling. The same Defence Minister who publicly stated that price is a secret negotiated with Mr. Macron. In my last speech, I made it very clear that the Defence Minister was contradicted by Mr. Macron himself, who personally told me, Mr. Manmohan Singh and Mr. Anand Sharma, that the French government and Mr. Macron have no issue with India being told the price of the Rafale jets. So friends, There are a number of holes in the Rafael story. And you will recall that the last time the Prime Minister came and listened to my speech, you will recall that the Prime Minister came and gave a long speech of 1.5 hours where he did not talk for 5 minutes about Rafael. So it is very clear, the Prime Minister does not have the guts to come to Parliament and confront the questions. The Defence Minister hides behind the AIDMK people and the Prime Minister hides in his room. Now, with your permission, Speaker Madam,
what to do?
I would like to play a little tape recording that has been released. That has been released today in the media. Do I have your permission, Speaker Madam? Do I have your permission, Speaker Madam, to play a little tape recording? Do I have your permission to play a little tape recording?
No, no.
This is a tape recording.
Speak whatever.
This is a tape recording of the Health Minister of Goa. Do I have your permission, Madam?
I don't have.
I can play it, Madam.
Yes. It is not allowed.
Ma'am. I would like to, in the spirit of the 21st century, I would like to play this recording.
No.
It is a recording of a minister, of a minister in the Goa government, where he is clearly stating something the chief minister of Goa has stated in a cabinet meeting.
Rahul ji, please listen to me. Nothing will go in a record like this. You allow to no. इस प्रकार के ना allegation करेंगे. You have to authenticate it. ऐसा recording नहीं जाता है. No, no. आप authenticate करें. आप लिखित. आप उसको लिखित में authenticate कर रहे हैं.
Give me the mic. Thank you. Ma'am, do I have your permission? Okay, madam, if you are not going to give me permission because they are scared, I will read the transcript of the recording.
You have to authenticate it.
Good evening, sir.
I'm sorry.
Boss, good evening. I called today.
Rahul ji, please listen to me.
No, no, no.
Are you authenticating?
I called today. There was a...
It will not go something.
Understand that they are very terrified of this type of thing.
Are you authenticating the statement?
So, ma'am, I will not play the tape.
Not.
I will not play the tape. If it makes you happy, I will not play the tape.
The House stand adjourned to meet again at 2:30.
As I mentioned, मैंने जैसे कहा था, मैं जो टेप रिकॉर्डिंग मेरे पास है उसे प्ले नहीं करूंगा.
कर ही नहीं सकता.
तो आपने जो बोला है, आपने जो बोला है वो मैं उसको सुनूंगा.
आप उसकी जिम्मेदारी लेना
करना पड़ेगा. तो दो तीन और सवाल उठते हैं. एक बड़ा सवाल उठता है कि पुराने कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में एचएल हवाई जहाज बनाती बैंगलोर में, बाकी प्रदेशों में हवाई जहाज बनता, और ये बहुत बड़ा कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है, तो लाखों युवाओं को इस राफेल हवाई जहाज बनाने का ऑनर मिलता, तो आपने एचएल से छीना और अनिल अंबानी को जो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दिया, अब फ्रांस में हवाई जहाज बनेगा.
व्यक्ति का नाम मत लो, उनके फर्म का हो तो ले.
मैम, अनिल अंबानी जी का भी नाम नहीं ले सकते. मैम, मना है. मैम, मना है. मैम, अनिल अंबानी का भी मना है. मैम,
ही इज नॉट द मेंबर ऑफ दिस.
नहीं, नॉर्मली मेंबर्स का नहीं लेना चाहिए, बट अनिल अंबानी का भी नहीं ले सकते.
नॉट मेंबर ऑफ दिस हाउस. ही इज नॉट मेंबर ऑफ दिस हाउस.
अच्छा मैम, नए रूल्स है मैम. No problem, ma'am. Ma'am, he's a member of the BJP, ma'am, maybe?
No, nothing. House president.
Okay, ma'am, I bow to your wishes.
I am asking
ma'am,
you,
can I call him double A?
Rahul ji, aisa nahi.
Ma'am, double A
keh sakta hu? Main rule ke hisab se bol rahi hu na. Aisa main meri
ma'am, double A bhi nahi keh sakta? Ma'am, double A?
Ye mujhe puch ke mat bolo, please. Don't do that.
तो डबल ए को कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दिया गया और पूरे के पूरे फ्रांस में हवाई जहाज बनेंगे। यहाँ जो युवा आए हैं इनके भी हाथों से रोजगार छीना गया, मेक इन इंडिया की बात हुई, बट राफेल मामले में दुनिया का एक सबसे बड़ा डिफेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मेड इन फ्रांस हुआ, नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने करवाया। थोड़ा समय सुप्रीम कोर्ट के बारे में भी कहना चाहता हूं। सरकार के लोग कहते हैं कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने राफेल मामले पर निर्णय लिया, बट रियलिटी ये है कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने सिर्फ ये कहा है कि राफेल पे इंक्वायर करना हमारे ज्यूरिसडिक्शन में नहीं है। सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने ये नहीं कहा है कि जेपीसी लागू नहीं होनी चाहिए और पार्लियामेंट्री इंक्वायरी नहीं होनी चाहिए। एक और आर्टिकल आज आया है, वायर मैगजीन में एक आर्टिकल आया है जिसमें लिखा है कि डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री की फाइल नोटिंग्स में डिफेंस मिनिस्टर ने कहा है कि प्रधानमंत्री जी को राफेल के नेगोशिएशन में इंटरफियर नहीं करना चाहिए। यह बहुत बड़ा सवाल है, क्या ऐसी कोई फाइल नोटिंग है जिसमें डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री के अफसरों ने लिखा है कि प्रधानमंत्री को राफेल के नेगोशिएशन में इंटरफियर नहीं करना चाहिए? यह बहुत बड़ा मुद्दा है, इसका भी जवाब प्रधानमंत्री जी दें। आखिरी बात मैं कहना चाहता हूं कि ये जो टेप निकली है इसमें गोवा के चीफ मिनिस्टर ने कैबिनेट मीटिंग में सबके सामने बोला, मेरे पास राफेल की फाइलें पड़ी हुई हैं, मेरे घर में पड़ी हुई हैं, और राफेल का पूरा सच मेरे पास है और मुझे और गोवा के चीफ मिनिस्टर ने बोला मेरे पास
एक मिनट सुनिए, आप एक डिफेंस मिनिस्टर कह सकते हो गोवा चीफ मिनिस्टर के नाते? नहीं, जो भी हो गोवा चीफ मिनिस्टर नहीं, बात समझो तो सही, आप मुझे क्यों रोकने के लिए मजबूर हो?
Sorry, ma'am. Not Chief Minister of Goa, ex Defence Minister of India. An even more important man has the files of Rafael in his cupboard. He has stated this to his cabinet, and it has been authenticated by a cabinet minister of the government of Goa who belongs to the BJP. मैडम, आमतौर से राफेल का मामला शुरू हुआ, हमने सोचा था दाल में कुछ काला है और हमने शुरुआत की, प्राइसिंग की बात निकली, अनिल अंबानी की बात निकली, प्रोसीजर की बात निकली, मैक्रॉन जी ने टिप्पणी दी, हॉलैंड जी ने टिप्पणी दी, 2 साल के बाद पता लगा दाल में कुछ काला नहीं है, दाल ही काली है, काली दाल है। मैडम, वी डिमांड ए जेपीसी इन दिस मैटर। बीजेपी के नेताओं से मैं कहता हूं, डरने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है। जेपीसी लागू कीजिए, दूध का दूध पानी का पानी हो जाएगा। देश को पता लग जाएगा कि नरेंद्र मोदी जी, जिन पे देश ने भरोसा किया था, नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने स्वयं अनिल अंबानी जी के जेब, सॉरी डबल ए के जेब में, डबल ए के जेब में 30,000 करोड़ रुपए डाले, पूरे के पूरे प्रोसीजर को नष्ट किया, बाईपास किया। डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री के लोगों ने इतराज किया। एचएल के वर्कर से कॉन्ट्रैक्ट छीन कर फ्रांस की एक कंपनी को दिया गया। तो मैडम, हम चाहते हैं कि जेपीसी लागू होए और जो सच्चाई देश सुनना चाहती है वो देश के सामने आए। आखिरी बात, कल अपने इंटरव्यू में नरेंद्र मोदी जी थके हुए लगे थे, घबराए हुए लगे थे, और उन्होंने कहा कि मेरे ऊपर कोई उंगली नहीं उठा रहा है। नरेंद्र मोदी जी, पूरा देश आप पर उंगली उठा रहा है। धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।